The sweetness and the sorrow. Wish me luck the same to you. But I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for.
You are all our peers. We, deaf actors, have come a long way. 35 years, I have been seeing so much work out there, and all this time, I've watched all of your films, and I pay the deepest respect to all of you. Is Meryl Streep here? She is, yes? Oh my God, okay. Okay, I love you. I love you. Okay, this validates the fact that we deaf actors can work just like anybody else. We look forward to more opportunities for deaf actors, deaf culture. Thank you. So, and I'm gonna teach you one thing. Do this. This is, I love you. Thank you, we love you.
How do you pick yourself up, though? When you get down, we all get down. How do you turn things around for yourself? What's your way of picking yourself up when you're feeling a bit crummy and like, ugh, I just can't be bothered?
I eat milk duds. Candy.
Me too. That's why the camera only shows me from this height.
Did he find a cure for cancer? Because if he found a cure for cancer, I think that would be interesting. I think that was something we should share.
Yeah.
But he didn't. He wants to find a cure for cancer, and he wants to say that in the State of the Union. You know what my response would be? Well, me too. But is this the first time you had that thought?
Sign Union again. That was cool. No, it must have been a different word.
This is probably the greatest assemblage of Democratic talent since the last time Jed Bartlett dined alone. As you can see,
a lot of people. 35,
30.
Hey,
Margaret.
Have you ever done a game night with Cameron Manheim? Because she's extremely competitive, angrily so.
I know she plays all the time, and I don't play with game people. That's not my thing. I'm a sore loser. I'm a sore loser. That's it.
Well, why don't you just hear? You can tell her yourself. Please welcome Cameron Manheim.
Hey!
Wait. You didn't say you don't play with gay people, did you? Because without gay people, there are no games. They're the best.
Exactly right. True. Cameron, you are very fiercely, fiercely competitive. I'm so intimidated. You have to win. It's your thing. You have to win. How is that fun for the other players?
I like it.
Oh, yeah, for sure. It is so much fun. I don't play for money. I play for honor. And if you are in the game and you care about winning,
no.
We're going to have fun.
No. Your nose is growing as you're speaking right now. Cameron.
And I asked myself, should I ask Brad to lunch next time we go work together again? You know, maybe I should do that now.
Yes.
You pay.
Okay. You gonna study with me? Huh? Excuse me? Hey, come here. You study with me? With my lungs. Oh, thank you. Would you rather play? Okay, ready? Ready? Say it. Right here.
Did you win?
No. My thoughts exactly.
I think we need to have a rematch.
We should, but how can I make the pumpkin better?
You know?
In your honor, we're going to put this up on the web. He should have won. I should have won Celebrity Apprentice. He should have won the Meatloaf Pumpkin Contest, okay? Let's go and we'll cry together.
Like, you're together all day, so it was a time to sort of shake your Etch-a-Sketch.
I get that.
Usually Richard Schiff and I would just take a nap together.
All right, I missed that one. All right.
Well, and for those listening, Jack is Marley's interpreter and also probably one of her three dearest friends of her lifetime. And they have spent so many memories together. And honestly, just seeing Jack here in this interview with us is like seeing a celebrity, because he's such a big part of the Marley Matlin story.
Let me ask you,
Who's the three friends? Let's see. Who are we talking about? The three friends that she mentioned.
Oh, I was assuming it was Ruthie, Liz, and Jack. Do I have it right?
Good for you.
I mean, what? Yes, Seth, were you going to say something, Seth?
No. I was going
to. I thought your mom was ready to say something like that.
I didn't agree with him.
Say hi to Pete.
to say hi.
I thought that we would act like we'd been together the night before and had sex, and you left something at my apartment, but then it turns out to be totally innocent.
Brooke, that was my idea.
But I'm on first. Too bad.
But it's really my idea.
But I'm on first. What did she say? Jack, what did she say?
What a cunt. Larry. Are you deaf or something?
Marley?
Yes, hello. Listen, you gotta come out of there, Larry, because there are a lot of people who really care about you.
That's sweet of you to say, Marley, but I'm not coming out.
Larry, I brought some clips from my movie. I need to promote it.
Up here we will be. A little gambling is going over me. Look at me.
Oh.
Want to say I'm a really, really big fan of yours. Children of a Lesser God was amazing. You won an award, and your book was so candid and so courageous, and your work on The West Wing is incredible.
Shut up! You're fair to yourself. You think it feels good being made fun of? But how about I do an impression of you? Okay, let me do it. I'm Alec. I'm an arrogant little whore. All I do is not exercise. Eat Oreos. I complain that I'm not in more movies. Hear me walk it down the street.
No.
Huh?
No, it doesn't, Miss Matlin.
Does it? No. No, it doesn't.
No.
You know, you've made fun of me more than twice. Twice, a Family Guy. Did you ever think once of calling me and asking me to use my own voice?
No, no, I swear, Miss Matlin, we did. We called, but the phone just rang and rang. And...
You want to learn some savvy quotes?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.